That smell was strong. Might be behind us now. I mean, they might be like in that field.
Whoa! Oh, fuck's sake! Jesus!
Okay, get the thing out. Because there's a fucking big... Sorry, there's a... You'll have to... there's a big snake, like, in that bush right over here. It flared up, and then...
And then we...
And then we went, whoa! are you rolling?
Yeah. Oh, one second.
This used to be an elephant migration route, clearing the way for thousands of other species to supplement biodiversity. Sadly, they can no longer cross these lands, and only one elephant remains in the Garden Route National Park. This is Clyde Berning. In November 2020, he realized that he had to use his privilege of movement to traverse the Eden to Addo migration route, just as species had done for centuries, but cannot anymore due to human fragmentation of the landscape. Restriction of movement, it turns out, is the greatest threat facing the planet today.
It's actually about the next generation and what kind of a world are they inheriting.
Sorry, have you ever seen a guy called Damien Schumann? He's about yay high. He's a bit like a French legionnaire.
I guess that's me.
One thing I just remembered is I must actually download
the maps. And with the support of his father, Dr. Pete Berning, and conservation biologist Dick Carr, we would run the 360-kilometer elephant migration route from the Addo Elephant National Park through the Baviaanskloof and rest in the Garden Route National Park, where today only one elephant remains alive. Our goal is to have a corridor between these mega parks recognized as protected land, so all species can move as freely as we can, making it possible for the likes of the Neisner elephant to return to its herd.
Okay, let's run this.
Right.
Yeah.
Let's give it a go.
Perfect, guys.
Hello, Mr. Lucky Phylum.
The whole area is meant to be covered in spec one.
Guessing this is a degree of game fence. What kind of creature do you think would eat a tortoise like this?
Showing off. Two crows having fights with black eagles, guys.
It's a bigger threat than climate change or anything like that.
This is Joan Berning, director of the Eden to Addo Corridor Initiative, and Clyde's mom.
And of course, climate change affects loss of biodiversity. But the biggest threat to loss of biodiversity is, in fact, fragmentation of the landscape. Most people think about parks as being big fenced-in areas. But that is, of course, similar to having a family and having inbreeding. By fencing them in, you create a sort of stasis, a genetic stasis. And the solution is to establish corridors connecting protected areas.
So I'm looking forward to running with Damien, because we've never run together, supporting biodiversity ourselves, and then also seeing what running 350Ks is actually like. I'm voting for the button.
Are you?
Yeah. Ching chong cha.
Ah, damn it.
Flow of life.
Fragmentation is human interference with the landscape that creates islands of habitation. It can be any barrier that prevents a species from migrating from one point to another, such as roads, fences, or alien vegetation.
Maybe 200 years ago, there were thousands of elephants in this region. So now we're left with just one. If there's a new hike route or a new mountain bike route, initially she will cross that route, but then slowly but surely she'll move away from that route. So the elephant is a symbol for all wildlife and for biodiversity and for what we are doing to nature, pushing it into smaller and smaller little alcoves and parcels of land.
Do humans have a place in the forest if we're actually just dividing and fragmenting the landscape? As we can have a force on some animals, the other animals will have a force upon us. And if we are open to ebbing and flowing with these forces that are stronger and weaker than us, well then everything ultimately always stays in balance.
Should we take this track up?
Yeah, so first part of proper nav. First off-track little mission following riverbeds. The fun begins, eh?
The birds fly so as the light leaves your eyes. Hold on to your dream. Oh, I know you wanna scream. Since the day you're born, you're just a flower on your own. Waiting for the sun to blossom. Hoping to break through the storm.
The ease of movement through the landscape is definitely not what it used to be.
The Garden Route National Park and the Baviaans World Heritage Site are unfenced. So there's a huge opportunity to create connections between these parks so that there's a free flow of life.
The urban creep and the human influence does play a massive role, you see it.
And within that area we have Nama Karoo. We have succulent karoo, we have thicket, and we have fynbos, and we have forest. So just the fynbos has over 9,000 species.
I mean, there have only been a few occasions, and it was usually like up above, up on the top ridges of the Baviaanskloof, in these very isolated places that you really feel that wilderness. They're like the complete isolation from everything, and those moments are incredible. I mean, they're amazing.
Eden to Addo encourages farmers to protect the parts of their farms that are still wild and unusable. They then try to link these areas with neighboring tracts of land, so species have a safe passage between protected lands. This is known as a biodiversity corridor.
Well, life has nearly killed me, and my mind has put me on the edge.
The definitions of douche grade. Too steep to run, too flat to walk. And we've got 15 kilometers of that right now.
Though I can barely crawl, I've got to walk with his angels feet a tree.
I'm taking proper strain on my shins here. They're just locking up and not responding. A lot of pain. So that's slowing us down. I keep encouraging Demo to run, but he doesn't want to. He's quite stubborn, actually. I don't know how good his hearing is. So I don't know if you've heard that. He's quite stubborn, actually.
We're almost at the end of the douche grade climbing.
Amazing. It's just interesting to feel that kind of pain and the strain and the frustration of it.
And then in theory it's progressively downhill from there.
In theory. Just going to do what we gotta do.
Oh man. 42 k's to paradise.
I got such a long way to go.
Like, my biggest fear up until now has been that I won't be able to finish. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, in my mind, I'll crawl, you know, if I have to, and I'll just keep moving. It's not about proving anything to myself or anyone, but rather finishing the job.
Yeah.
And the job is to get there.
Our movement through it and the reason they do the hike is to do what elephants would otherwise be doing. And that is to support biodiversity and the flow of life.
Part of the thing that tends to affect your life, which is that, because it's not only in one spot, you know, you usually morph into your hamstring and your left hand.
It is that.
If you start to doubt yourself, it's over before it's begun.
This is Pete Berning, Clyde's dad.
I'm the marriage counsellor when there's little tiffs between the two of you. I'm the physio, the chef. I'm the driver, shopper. I'm the logistics technician. I'm a psychologist. I'm a masseur. I'm a motivational expert when it comes to my son maybe being a bit down. And then I'm the doctor, which is along with the physiotherapy skills that I have.
The part he's leaving out is that he's summited four major mountains and been on expeditions to the North and South Pole, mostly in his 60s.
You're going to have your downs, you've got to push through them. You learn to listen to your body, to pace yourself, to keep mentally strong. You're going to experience pain, you're going to experience fatigue. If there's a problem, put it right straight away, or before it even becomes a problem.
Day 6, starting out, overcast and a bit chilly. We are now about to commence the crossing of the Coca River.
Oh. Well,
it looks like
hill road.
There is a bit of a clearing in the bush over there.
Oh, now we're too far right.
Yeah.
Hey, bro. Like, I want some dry clothes on the other side, eh?
Just making some headway. I know that at some point today I'll get left behind. No, this is a team effort, not one oak looking after another oak. It's his responsibility to go at his pace, my responsibility to go at my pace, and somewhere between we look out for each other. The oak has gotten lost a few times and tends to be a bit of a lost cause.
May I ask why I'm doing this? It's for little creatures that don't have the opportunity to run around like I do.
He is the more experienced. And I need to remind myself to be humble and be ready to fail and accept. And then just, you know, fall 7 times, stand up 8. And
getting a little bit nervous. I haven't seen Clyde yet.
But that said, sometimes feel just a little bit babysat in it.
We either bundubash like straight across.
We'll see how this plays out though, if he's gonna get cross with me for doing this. I don't know.
Ta-da!
Clothed!
Oh, there he is.
Howdy! Ah! Ready for some no man's land?
Yeah!
Yeah!
Sure, why not? Yeah. Got nothing else to do.
Yeah.
We are creating structures which are not assisting in in a symbiotic relationship, you know, like between people and animals.
I've lost hope at times when I consider how far down a road that doesn't work, a way that doesn't work, we've gone. But this run has changed my mind.
When you've got someone pointing out and saying that that's actually meant to be exceptionally lush, and was, you know, a couple of years back, it strikes home pretty hard.
I get quite emotional thinking about it, but I go back home with like I can look at my kids and feel like it's okay, you know. We can still do something. We can make a difference here. We can really make a difference.
You too. You happy too. You band of cousins.
That's what we're setting out to cross.
You bond of brothers.
Is there?
Hi.
And all those runners out there in Zanzi, be they Carlitz, Sands, or Oshahovsky, will rue the day they are abed today.
Demo!
And not on the trail with Schumann and Berning.
Did it fire?
Fire!
There were more than a few occasions when I thought maybe I wasn't going to make it.
major motivating force was family. And then that one lonely elephant in Nisner, and the idea, just the idea that these animals have been cut off from each other.
So far, I think we're still in good spirits. How can you not be when you've got these kind of views?
Like for me, the takeaway is spending time with family. It's learning about South Africa and the South African landscape.
Rhino poop was lying in the road.
And having the opportunity to test and challenge myself in a natural environment.
Stay in the moment and just keep putting one foot in front of the other.
So what did you learn, Damien? Running is self-propelled, and in the absence of technology, one learns their true place in an ecosystem.
This looks like a bit of an animal track. Maybe it's our trail.
It's difficult to survive out there, but suffering creates value. You may be small, but you're not insignificant. And once you have experienced a truly wild place, the fragmented world we come from seems incredibly troubling, inbred, and restricted in every way. The age of living in cages needs to end.
That is exhausting.
We have to end it, the special.
Oh, wow.
The diversity of the biomes, as you know, that you've been through, that says it all.
I think it's strange these places we go from Eden to Addo. So many things that I just did not know. Oh, 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 sweet trail of mine.
Oh, 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 sweet trail.